here with Ernest Lau, manager and chief engineer at the Board of Water Supply. Now, the Board of Water Supply has just released a draft of their water master plan. Ernest, can you tell us, why did you guys create this master plan?
Water being so important to our community, it's important that our water infrastructure was always going to be there to serve our community today and into the future. Because of that, we needed a roadmap, the latest version of a roadmap looking forward 30 years to tell us what we need to do to take care of the water system and our water resources to continue to provide that service to our community.
Great. So how does this master plan differ from other plans you may have had in the past?
Well, the board's always done planning, long-term planning. This one's a little different. I've set the horizon or the time for the plan up 30 years, so we're looking a little further into the future. And we're also, a part of this plan, we did a comprehensive condition assessment of all of our assets. We looked at the condition of our pipelines, looked at 21,000 feet of our pipelines of various sizes, including the large transmission mains, to see if we could see if there's any problems with those pipes. We also looked at 171 reservoirs, and over 180 pumping stations.
That's huge. That must have taken a lot of time to do.
It was a tremendous amount of effort, and my staff and our consultant also worked very hard over the last couple of years to do that.
Okay, I'm sure this master plan, like you said, it's comprehensive, but can you kind of just give us an overview?
Well, the master plan had to look at, for the next 30 years, where would water demand and the population on this island be? Currently, right now, we serve almost 1 million people every day with water. We pump on average 145 million gallons a day to serve our community. So the master plan looked at those population projections, looked at projected demand into the future, looked at the condition of the infrastructure, and what kind of projects are necessary to actually take care of the infrastructure to ensure water service to our community into the future.
And in coming up with this master plan, you also used updated technology.
That's one big difference. Technology, as you know, and your cell phones are now smartphones. They're like little computers that you didn't have 30 years ago. Likewise, the tools to do master planning and condition assessment weren't there 30 years ago. And in this plan, we use the latest tools available in the industry.
Now, if people want to review this master plan, is there a way that they can get a copy?
I'm glad you asked that question, Trini. Copies are available at our boardofwatersupply.com website. They can download the 200-page master plan draft or a 30-page summary for them to, maybe it's a little easier for them to understand. They can also look at hard copies at public libraries all over Oahu. We're going to put hard copies of the full master plan in each of those libraries. So if they don't have a computer, they can go to the library and look at the plan.
Okay, that's great. And I hear that you're also asking for people's feedback and comments.
Water being so important to our community, it's important that we get feedback from our from the people in this island on our master plan. So they can provide that electronically by email. Email us at bwswatermasterplan@hbws.org or mail comments in to the Postal Service to 630 South Baratania Street, Honolulu, Hawaii 96843. Okay. And we would like those comments in writing. The deadline for receiving comments is September 12th of this year. So we appreciate all the comments we can get.
Great. Ernest, thank you so much.
Thanks, Trini.
Thank you. It's so great to have an organization, any organization really, to be looking decades ahead, coming up with a master plan, and this affects all of us.
It does. You know, I know realtors, developers that are anxious about this because looking where the population is going to be 30 years down the road, knowing that they're planning for it, there's new developments, Coral Ridge, you can kind of see where things are going to be happening property-wise in the future. So yeah, I'm going to be heading to the library to check that out a little bit later.
Good. Mm-hmm. We're going to have because they're asking people to send their comments. We're going to have that information on our website as well. So
Good
if you missed it, not to worry. Just log on to khon2.com. Mm-hmm.